he's not elbow to elbow, his elbows are still coming and there's no room. Everyone, for some reason, when they're locked, even if they're like this, there's so much room. My chest is all I gotta come here and squeeze my elbows in and tight so there's no room right here. My elbows shouldn't move. So when I'm going, like, I don't want to slide. I want to just pull that straight into me. There's a nail, a stake going through my chest into his back right here. And I shouldn't move from this position the whole time. So I'm dragging up here. We don't move throughout the whole thing. So he's back on top of me.
You gotta glue, squeeze so tight that everything's glued or spiked or however you want to say it. Everything's tight. Your elbow squeeze in. And you and your shoulder behind your shoulder blade, try to drive your shoulder down on the mat. Both feet surrounding it up here. Once that hip comes up, drive that knee under. You know, you gotta try to plant his chest and face. You might have to drive his face across the mat for a little bit before you go. But all the pressure's gotta be going forward. One foot in the center. I see some of you guys trying to gut, and you're both feet out to the side here, one on each side, so one in the center, one off to the side, squeezing tight on the hips, shoulder in, and off here, grab that knee under.
Now that's the perfect gut bench, if everything went fine, but obviously that doesn't always happen. Someone's going to have good defense, and your lock is going to slip, so when it happens, if it does slip, it has to stay right here now. When I jump sides, I can't switch my lock with it. It has to stay right there. You jump sides.
Either keep it there or you can grab right onto the hip. Whatever works better. Lock's got to stay tight. Right away, shoulder in the right position, driving. Right to it. Don't let your lock slip. And switch it all the way back over as you jump. You don't want to be here. Jump side here over here. They lose all that pressure. Squeeze, keep it locked there. Right to it. Elbows locked right on that hip.
So that's a low gut. Now we gotta go to a high gut. A lot of us are having, we're just trying to, we're driving on our head, but we're not running forward at all. Where he's at, you kind of, you have good, but you're just coming here, you're pedaling. I'm afraid you're going to get called because you're just a headbutt. I start right in the back of his neck, driving straight down. You know, so I start right here, locks right under his chin, right here. Same thing as before. I'm squeezing my elbows in and I'm rolling it and tightening everything up. And I start here and I drive up his head. And short, choppy steps. So now this one, my feet are on both sides right here. So I just stay here low, right, 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 right. Now I'll feel a break. When our side breaks, choose that side, elbows up. But I stay low when I drive into a short chopper step right here. And I think you guys are pulling and rolling them over. So here, start low. Up. Choose the side.
Now I have a hard time doing the high jump with this lock. Some of you guys might help. Trying to finger lock headings and kind of just drive your knuckles up into the sternum a little bit. And you're funneling them over, kind of helps bring your hips up. But if you have kind of weird, well, depends on just how flexible your wrists are. I like here, same, everything else is the same, but just gives you a little more room.
I guess I should probably say defense to that. For me, it's pretty simple. Just gotta get the high gut. I just post on my head right here, and it looks funny. But I just pull it right here so I can't drive it down. So now I can't go forward. We said it's stupid, but it works.
The only other thing too is, it seems counterintuitive because he's trying to get your hips to come up, but if they're going for that high gut, just come up into a base quick. So he's here, knees up, into a base here. That's gonna take away a lot of his pressure. If you're ready, he's gonna go there, but as soon as they go down, you got a lot of momentum. Jump forward, scrape that lock. Don't do the game to break his wrist, but as soon as you feel that lock loosen up, we're going to come down, you got to be jumping forward, and that pressure can come up and down. We should break that lock pretty quick. So don't give them time to get down there and get a little lock in tight. As soon as you feel your hips about to break, just pop up, base up.
Alright, so I know that's a lot of information. I want you guys going out working the defense and offense of this, getting a bunch of different situations there. So from high gut, low gut, and we'll come back in and do a little bit more from parterre.